Days of sanding, prepping. I did cut a few corners in few places because A, don't have time, B, I don't really care, C, yeah, it will do. Ideally, you would sand down some places like this where you can see the outline of the tape completely flat if you want it perfect, because this is not meant to be a perfect thing. Also, I would be able to sort of fix it afterwards, just sand the final thing. I think the mold is absolutely ready, so now I need to cut a template from the sheets, because we're only going to use three layers, I think, because I want it really light and I want it semi-flexible. So I think it's going to be one Kevlar, the main part, the on the outside, and then on the inside we either do the same as I've done with all the other parts. The middle part will be e-glass and then carbon on the inside, or just two layers of carbon. That's it. Let's cut, measure, and then... Dry means only one thing. Now we can bloody demold this. Actually, I'm really excited to see what it's gonna look like. I think I've made all the right steps to ensure that it's actually gonna be decent looking, but until we open it, we'll never know.
72 hours late.
You see, you can actually tell exactly why it doesn't want to release properly, because it's all offsets. Anyways, I'm gonna pretend that, oh, so easy. It wasn't easy. 2 days I tried to release this. Such a difficult shape, and also I had some mechanical lock here and there. I did cut a few corners, like I said before, but this thing is super light. Even without trimming, I reckon this is a kilo and a half maximum. So it's definitely a lot lighter than the original one. And to be fair, it doesn't look too bad. Nothing really cracked. I did have to cut the blanking plate for the air vent, but obviously I'll fix it. I'll make the new vent. And then just needs a bit of trimming. Yeah, sanding some of the bits where it pulled off the gel coat. Yeah, overall, I'm pretty happy with this one. So let's get it prepped and then throw this bloody thing on a skip. Well, obviously I'll keep it, but this was not enjoyable in any way. So anyways. Okay, so what do we have now? We have this. I'm not going to pretend that this happened a week ago, because it happened a couple of months ago and I was just sitting there, and now I need to finish the video, so I'm recording it post scriptum. Anyways, is the finished bumper? Well, it's not 100% finished. I still need to, and I made those little ducts. They don't look very pretty, but you're never going to see them. Again, they're from offcuts of Kevlar. They're basically going to fit inside here like that, and it will just all be glued. And I also bought those fancy air ducts from Corvette. I don't know, what is it? Something Z, whatever. They actually fit incredibly well on the Clio. And basically they will go like this, something like that. Fit it on the car, so I have air ducts. Overall, I am very happy. There's a few spots which are a bit meh, but it's okay. At the end of the day, lightness was the key, and I think it's time to tell you whether I was on point with my prediction or not. 1.73. I think that's not bad. That's not bad for a full bumper. That's really, really not bad. So I'm gonna finish this one here. Guys, thank you very much for watching it. I guess this is how you make a bumper from Kevlar or carbon. Would I do it again? This was so difficult, especially for the mold, then release this and also to lay this stuff. And it's just not, I get lots of people asking me, oh, can you do this custom? How much would you charge? Expensive. It's very expensive. It's extremely time consuming. This bumper overall, I mean, it a week for the mold, and this at least 2 weeks of constant non-stop work. Materials wise, probably around £350, just materials, maybe even more, because I actually had to make a mold. So yeah, I hope the wife is not going to watch this, but who am I kidding? Yeah, guys, thank you very much. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.